Now, suppose you implement par4 in this way. Let's replace par4 with a procedure call. This procedure call takes the function or the loop body as well as an iteration range, in this case 1 to n. The procedure call itself is implemented as follows. We figure out how many iterations there are, call that little n. If there's only one iteration, then we'll call foo on a. Otherwise, we'll do divide and conquer, essentially breaking the iteration range a to b into a to m minus 1 and m to b, where m is approximately the midpoint. The scheme will give you the usual sort of binary tree recursion. So if you ask what's the span of this DAG, it should be logarithmic. Now what I've just given you is a much more realistic way to implement a parallel for loop. So what I want you to do from now on is to assume this implementation. That means if I tell you that the loop body of a par4 has constant cost and I ask you what the span will be log n. And again, this is in contrast to assuming that the span is, say, constant cost, which is what it would be in theory.